It's always been about me, myself, and I. If our relationships were nothing but a waste of time, I never wanted to be anybody's other half. I was happy saying I'd love it wouldn't last. That was the only way I knew till I met you. You make me wanna say I do, I do, I do, 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 do. Yeah, I do, I do, I do, 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 do. Cause every time before it's been like maybe yes and maybe no. I can live without it, I can let it go. Ooh, what did I get myself into? You make me wanna say I do, I do, I do, 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 do.
We are gathered here today to celebrate the marriage of Allison Mann and Keith Glover. Today is the day that they will formally and publicly make their promises to one another. Before we begin, let us take a moment to pray. Thank you, Lord, for this wonderful day, incredible day that you have given us to celebrate the love and commitment of Allison and Keith. You have divinely placed this couple together, and as they walk through life, we pray that you will give them guidance, wisdom, and direction in their marriage. Let no one and nothing come between them but for your love for them, their love for you, and their love for one another. We thank you for the family and friends who have gathered here to bless and support them in their marriage. We ask your blessing upon them as well. May their marriage be one of tenderness, understanding, and great love. Lord, we now ask your blessing upon them today and for always. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. At this time, Tyson has been given the honor of reading Corinthians, and I'll ask him to come right on up. Can you take the mic and read it, or do you need me to hold it?
I can.
There you go. Let me get it. Step out. You can read to them and them.
Love is patient. Love is kind. Am I? Is it on? All right. Love is patient. Love is kind. What? Right. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always preserves. Love never fails.
Great job, Tyson. Okay. Allison, you gotta let him go. Good job, Tyson. They're introducing to each other to themselves here. They're, hi, how are you? You guys are funny. I love this couple. I've had a good time with them on the phone. Marriage is more than any one single event or promise. It's a series of decisions that have been made and will continue to be made over and over again every day. Marriage is a promise that definitively proclaims Allison and Keith's care and concern for the one whom they each love the most in this world. Marriage is a promise that is renewed daily through a couple's actions and a responsibility taken on in the spirit of faith, hope, and love. It's a union that brings comfort in times of sadness and heightens our greatest joys. Although this, of course, is a high point, marriage is also a journey and not just a destination. Allison and Keith's wedding story began when they met through some mutual friends. They started going with a group of friends up to Apollo Beach to hear Elvis Billy Lindsay. I don't know. Ah, he's going to be here later. Elvis is coming. Elvis is waiting in the air conditioning.
He's a smart one.
Yeah. It was their every Thursday night outing, and on their first date, they went to Apollo Beach to hear Kevin, Billy's brother, do a show. They always loved dancing the night away together, and it seemed early on that they were very comfortable with each other, and they enjoyed sharing all about their families. One thing that drew them together was their personal relationship with our Heavenly Father. Besides their kids and grandkids, that was the most important thing to each of them. Allison could see a strong faith relationship in Keith, and the rest of the details just seemed to fall into place. Neither one of them was looking for Mr. or Mrs. Wright, but they are both thankful. Oh, that's for sure, your friends are saying. But they are so thankful that God put them both right where he wanted them in each other's lives. Allison and Keith, I'm sure I speak for every one of your friends when I say, may all of your journeys and the pathways that you explore and share together lead you to a lifetime of happiness. All of you are the most important and have been the most influential people in their lives. All of the time and conversations that you have had with Allison and Keith, even before they met, have helped to make them who they are and who they needed to be, first to find themselves and then to find one another. All of you have shared in their best and their worst days, and you are an irreplaceable part of their yesterdays, their today, and all of their tomorrows. For each and every one of you is among the greatest gifts that life and God could have ever brought to them. All of you are those that they can proudly and honorably call family and friends. Yay, and they love you back. Look at that. I got them. A wedding is more than a celebration of love which lives in our bride and groom's hearts today. It reaches into the future and proclaims their intentions for that which tomorrow shall hold. A couple or a wed are joined not only by the mutual affection and love that they share, but also by their hopes and their dreams and their promises of what will be. The promises and vows that they make on this day shall guide them into their common future. And I'm going to take a moment to ask them if they're prepared to make these promises. Keith, just so you remember, the right answer is we do, okay? Right. We do. All right.
Let me think about that.
Think about that. We do. That's all you got to remember. Allison, I have another one. All right, here we go. Allison and Keith, do you pledge your love to one another wholly and fearlessly without restraint? And do you vow that you will continue to work together to spark creativity and inspire Elvis' passion in all aspects of your life together? We do. And do you pledge that you will always be there to comfort, soothe, and heal one another, and that you will stand together, proving that the tides may change, but your love will always remain constant? And do you pledge to one another a stable home that will always be a safe haven and sanctuary to body, mind, and spirit, a place that shall sustain and support and nourish your roots as you branch forth and grow into all that it is that shall be your life together? For some reason, I already know, and I know your friends know, that you're already living that life. At this time, Samuel has been given the honor. Sam, he's going to read a poem. I believe it's called Love is Sincere. Do you need me to hold this for you, or you got it?
Okay. Yeah, he's got it.
Love must be sincere. Not what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in love. Honor one another above yourselves, never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual favor, serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer, share with the Lord's people who are in need, practice hospitality, bless those who are pursuit you, bless and do not curse. Rejoice with those who rejoices, mourn with those who mourn, live in harmony with one another.
Got it. Good job. Give him a hug. Good job. That's Samuel, you're forgetting somebody. Come on over here. Good job, Samuel. At this time, I'll ask my bride to pass her flowers off to her maid of honors, maids of honors, maidens of honors. And I'd like the two of you to step behind this table over here, the sand ceremony table. In front of you is a heart-shaped vessel and a central vase. I'd like you to pick this up hand over hand together, and I'd like you to pour the contents into the big jar in front of you that will become a memento of this day in which your wedding vows were spoken. That sand is actually sand from under your feet. Clumpy. It's all right. It's on our feet, he says. That's good. That's good. Dump the rest. Dump the rest. Your relationship is symbolized through the pouring of these two individual containers of sand, each representing all that you were, all that you are, and all that you'll ever be. Each one can stand on its own and be whole without the need of anything else. But when the two are combined, they represent an entirely new and extraordinary love relationship. But I'd like to celebrate you as individuals before you met. So what I'd like you to use is half your sand and pour a single layer, starting with my beautiful bride, using about half the sand, a single layer. This will represent you as an individual, unique. And now, in the heart-shaped vessel, I'd like you to blend the rest of your sands together. Yep. That's perfect. And now put those down. And Keith, I'd like you to pick this vessel up, put your hand on top of it, and shake it up so those grains of sand can never be separated and poured into the individual containers again. Oh, shake it up good, man. Yeah, don't. And together, I've heard a comment out there from the Peanut Gallery, looks like blues rule. I'd like the two of you to pour the blended sand together, representing you as a united couple. The life that each of you has experienced until now individually will hereinafter be inseparably united, for the two shall become one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into the individual container, so will your lives become, so will your marriage be, and so will your future. So thank you. You may step ahead. Yay. Allison and Keith, yeah, it's like a shop project. They got the right answer. All right. A science project. Allison and Keith, may your love always be as constant as the never-ending waves behind you, flowing endlessly from the depths of the sea. Just as the waters touch and nourish the many shores of the earth, may your love be a moving sea between the shores of your souls. Just as there will never be a morning without the ocean's flow, may there never be a day without your love for one another. Now, Allison and Keith, I know you took a considerable effort to write what we call personal vows, a statement that they're going to read to one another. And today is the public affirmation and acknowledgement of all that you are to each other. Of course, your relationship will always be as it has been, yet there is definitely a power in the spoken word. So may that power bring you all the comfort, warmth, security, closeness, joy, and happiness that this world has to offer. Now, I think we should make Keith go first, don't you? So I'm going to give you all the time you need. I'd like you, Allison, to hold the mic for Keith, and Keith can hold it for you, and I'll go get him.
Oh. Go get him, Allison.
Isn't
it
cute?
Is there tissue paper in there?
I don't have a tissue paper.
That's all right. We'll live.
Blue for boy?
This is
pink for girl? Take the ribbon, slide the ribbon off.
It doesn't say I'm here, Anna.
Put it right into his mouth.
I want to hear it loud and clear.
Yes, dear. This day marks a new phase in my life, one in which I must strive to follow up on the fact that I've managed to show this woman some true happiness with her life, her family, my family, and our host of new and mutual friends. So now, my goal from here on is to keep her happy, and in so doing, I'm assured that if Allison is happy, Huggy will be happy. A win-win situation for both of us and all concerned.
Yay.
I got a hold now?
Here.
Okay.
Take the paper.
Oh, you got your cheaters?
Two pairs of glasses.
This is going to end.
Okay.
get that away from me.
No, you got to say it. You got to have it.
Keith.
Honey, you got to have it so they can hear you.
Be quiet. As we stand here today, on our wedding day, I am reminded of a verse that says, every good thing bestowed and every perfect gift is from above, coming from our Heavenly Father. I'm so thankful for His gift of grace and His gift of you to me. From day one, our love has been simple and comfortable, and that's what I've loved most about us. It's like my heart was saying to me, wake up, Allison, look at this man in your life. Look at what I have given you. He's what you've been praying for about for some time now, and you've been waiting for him. You are so kind and thoughtful and loving, and you have the sweetest heart. Your sense of humor and wit keep me laughing each day. With you, I feel loved and accepted and appreciated and safe. You see me for who I am. You have loved me at my best, and you've also loved me at my worst. But thank goodness that doesn't happen too often. You have shown me what love feels like again, and I thank you for that. With you in my life, nothing seems too difficult anymore. I marry you today with no hesitation or doubt. My commitment to you is absolute. This decision to commit my life to you and to our families together is one that I make very happily and with full of confidence. I pray that our marriage will be a gift to all those around us, just as your love is a gift to me.
You can kiss her if you want. Yeah. They actually asked me to play this song in completion. I was supposed to play it before, but I'll play it after. And this will give them a moment to catch up to themselves. This is called
You Look Pretty as a Picture.
Give You My Word by Billy Rice, right?
Nope. Your
there you go.
From now on, I will remember this vow I made to show I care, even as
this kind of sums it up for them, doesn't it?
Turn to brown, I will love you then as I do now. I give you my word.
They're already doing their first dance. Look at them.
Love you until.
Yep. Oh.
Onto the ring.
Onto the rings. I'm sorry. Actually, I only met the best man once, so I should check to see that the rings are, you're hired. All right, yeah. Hang on. Look at that. She's got five rings here. What's going on here? All right. Keep them on. The ring finger of the left hand is the side of the body that's been used for centuries for weddings because people believe that there was a vein that ran directly from the finger right to the heart. They also believe that the words used during the placing of the wedding band, that symbol of perfection, completion, and eternity, would resonate through to the heart and soul of both the giver and the receiver of that, the most monumental of all promises, the promise of a lifetime together as husband and wife. I'm going to start with Keith, and you want to answer to her, not me.
Okay.
Keith, do you take Allison to be your lawfully wedded wife?
Do you
vow to love her and care for her for as long as you both shall live? Do you accept her with all of her faults and strengths and offer yourself to her with all of your own faults and strengths? Do you promise to help her when she needs help and to turn to her when you need help?
Absolutely.
And most importantly, do you promise to be a faithful and loving companion and to always put the promises that you made on this day above all else?
I do.
I'm going to let you bring the rings over because there's so many of them, I want them to put them together. This is the ring you will put on your beautiful bride's finger.
Tell me Ellison first.
Yeah, it's all right. You can do that one. All right. Okay, step back. Okay. Repeat after me as you put the ring on. Actually, it should be her ring on. Actually, can I change that up?
Yeah, it's
you putting her ring on.
It's your show.
That's why I brought you. Go ahead. Bring her all those rings. It's him putting on her ring and saying, I do. I got the good one. The other one. Hang on to this. Here you go. Got it? Now, put the ring on her finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring that you may wear it as a symbol of the vows that we have made this day. I pledge you my love and respect. My laughter and my tears, with all that I am, I honor you. Now you place it the rest of the way. Okay. How do you feel, Allison? You ready? Allison, do you take Keith to be your lawfully? No, no, stay back. I've done this before. You're fine. I got you. Allison, do you take Keith to be your lawfully wedded husband? Do you vow to love him and care for him for as long as you both shall live? Do you accept him with all of his faults and strengths and offer yourself to him with all of your own faults and strengths? Do you promise to help him when he needs help and to turn to him when you need help? And most importantly, do you promise to be a faithful and loving companion and to always put the promises that you made on this day above all else? There you go. Now. Place the ring halfway on your beloved's finger. Repeat after me, look into his eyes. I give you this ring that you may wear it as a symbol of the vows that we have made this day. I pledge you my love and respect, my laughter and my tears, with all that I am. I honor you. There you go. You did it. Allison and Keith, the vows that you've just taken pledging love mean far more than the mere words ever could. May the gentle spirit move in you. May your years fulfill the beauty of the feelings expressed today. And may you always put these vows above the things that make life smaller, and may everything that you've said and done here today become a living truth in your lives. You are now completely and entirely husband and wife. You may now kiss your beautiful bride.
You make me wanna say I do. Yeah, I do. 'Cause every time before it's been like maybe yes and maybe no. I can live without it, I can let it go. Ooh, what did I get myself into? You make me wanna say I do. I do. Tell me, is it only me? Do you feel the same? You know me well enough to know that I'm not playing games. I promise I won't turn around and I won't let you down. You can trust I've never felt it like I feel it now. Baby, there's nothing we can't get through. I do love you.
necessary to survive.